Welcome to Hydrogeology 101 Pumping Tests. Today I'd like to talk about the Theis method for the analysis of non-steady-state pumping tests in confined aquifers. We're going to have a look at the Theis curve fitting method and also how we can do the calculations in Excel. In a previous video, we looked at the TEAM 1906 equation for steady-state flow to wells in confined aquifers. Now, one of the problems with steady-state is that you have to pump for quite a long time before your cone of depression stabilizes, at least until you reach quasi-steady state. So that's not always practical. Thankfully, in 1935, Charles Theis developed the first equation to describe the cone of depression around a pumping well under non-steady state conditions. He was inspired by the equation for heat flow and also received some help from a friend, which is always useful. The Theis 1935 solution, also known as the Theis non-equilibrium method, introduced a groundbreaking tool for estimating transmissivity and storativity of non-leaky confined aquifers. I'm going to leave you a link to the Theis 1935 paper in the description below, so you can have a look at it if you are interested. Here is the Theis equation, which applies to drawdown at any distance from a pumping well at any point in time. And it's quite simple. S equals the discharge of the pumping well, Q divided by 4 times pi times by transmissivity times by WU. Now WU is called the well function, and we'll have a look at it in a little while. The U of the well function equals the distance R squared from the pumping well times by storativity divided by 4 times by transmissivity times by time. So notice that the U term includes time. So S, the drawdown, is related to the well function, and U is related to time. Of course, it's important that we maintain the correct units, keep it consistent. I advise you to use meters for drawdown, meters cubed per day for discharge, meters squared per day for transmissivity. The distance should be in meters and the time in days. Remember that most mistakes made by hydrogeologists happen when they confuse the units. The Theis well function is an exponential integral, which includes Euler's constant, and it can be expanded as a convergent series as shown here. Now, I don't want to go into any details, but I'd just like you to appreciate that the well function is quite difficult to calculate if all you have is a calculator or pencil and paper. So in the old days, what we would do is go to the appendix of our book, for example, Krusman Derrida, and get the Theis well function from the table there and plot it up on log-log paper. So W, the well function, is always plotted on the y-axis. And as I mentioned before, W is related to drawdown. And 1 over U, or sometimes U, is plotted on the x-axis. And U is always related to time. Okay, let's have a closer look at the Theis equation. We can rewrite the equation for U in this way, so that T over R squared is on one side of the equation and the rest on the other side. And what you'll notice here is that Q over 4 pi T is a constant, and also S over 4 T is a constant, because these things don't change during the course of our pumping test. That assumes, of course, that you pump at a constant rate. As these are constants, then the relation between S and T over R squared must be similar to the relation between the well function and 1 over U. This is the fundamental basis of the Theis curve fitting method, where we plot S against time and the well function against 1 over U. The best way is to illustrate this using a practical example. I've taken some data from Todd Groundwater Hydrology, and we have here a well penetrating a confined aquifer, and it's pumped at a uniform rate of 2,500 cubic meters per day. We have an observation well located 60 meters away from the pumping well, and we should calculate the transmissivity and storativity of this confined aquifer. The first thing which we need to do is plot our data. The drawdown is always plotted on the y-axis, increasing upwards, and t over r squared is plotted on the x-axis. And what we do then is that we overlay our data onto our Theis curve and get the match point. Of course, that means that our data has to be plotted on transparent paper. Now, I'm going to try to illustrate this using modern technology. And if I make it a slightly bigger like this, maybe that'll work. Okay. So, yeah, here we go. So this is what I used to do 30 years ago. You'd match the data onto the type curve. And requires a little bit of skill, but something like this. We have a nice fit. So basically what we'd like to see is that all our data points fit nicely onto the Theis curve. Sometimes the very early data doesn't fit because of wellbore storage effects. So don't worry too much if maybe this very early data doesn't seem right, as long as the other data points plot nicely on the type curve, it's okay. So, next thing we do is we need to get what's called a match point. So basically, it's just a point on our graph where we can read off all the data. It's advisable to use a match point where WU, or the well function, is 1, and 1 over U is either 1 or 10, because that makes the subsequent calculations a lot easier. So here's our match point, and it is located, as I mentioned, WU, well, function is 1, 1 over U is 10. And then the next step is to read off the drawdown S and T over R squared from our data plot. S is approximately 0.18, because this is 0.1, that'll be 0.2 here. And T over R squared is 6.2 times 10 to the minus 4. Okay, and the next step is to calculate transmissivity and storativity from the equations. We calculate transmissivity from this equation here. So take the transmissivity out, put the drawdown in, and we have transmissivity equals 2,500 cubic meters per day divided by 4 times pi times the drawdown, which is from our match point, so 0.18, and times it by the well function, which conveniently from our match point has been taken as 1. So it's quite easy to calculate, and we end up with a transmissivity of just over 1,100 meters squared per day. Now that we've calculated the transmissivity, we can calculate the storativity, because the storativity equation, which is from the equation of U, is 4 times by the transmissivity, 1,105, times by T over R squared. Now, T over R squared is 6.2 times 10 to the minus 4, but we need to divide it by 1,440, because remember that time here is in minutes, and of course we have to convert it into days. And everything is then divided by 1 over U, which is 10. And we come up with 2 times 10 to the minus 4. Notice that it's always useful to round up storativity to 0 decimal places. Okay, so here is a review of our results. Transmissivity is about 1,100 meters squared per day, and storativity 2 times 10 to the minus 4. Okay, why did I show you all that? It's basically in case you come across an old report or maybe some old data so that you know what they were talking about when they're talking about the Theis curve fitting technique. Nowadays we have computers and we can calculate everything quite easily, including well function. There are quite a few commercial software available for the interpretation of pumping test data, but I encourage you to learn about first using Excel. The main reason for this is that you can get a better feeling for how the equations work, and also it's quite fun to do the calculations in Excel because it's free. Okay, this is the spreadsheet. It was first developed by Carlos Molano, so my thanks to Carlos if you're listening. All you need to do is change the data in the green squares and then adjust the Theis curve using this slider here for transmissivity and this one here for storativity. Our discharge is 2,500 meters cubed per day, our distance R is 60 meters, and we have our data here, time in minutes and drawdown in meters. If we have a look at this cell here, you can see the Theis equation, and you can see it's linked to our discharge, our distance, transmissivity, and storativity. One more thing to notice is we have here our well function, WU, which is working in VBA in the background. And also, because our time is in minutes, we've divided it here by 1,440. If your time was in seconds, you'd want to divide it by 86,400. Okay, let's have a look at the well function. We go to Visual Basic, you can see it here. This is password protected so that you don't delete something by mistake. Okay, so let's do our interpretation using Excel. Slide it down a bit. The first thing we need to do is we want to bring our Theis curve down towards the data, which means we want to reduce the drawdown, calculate the drawdown, which is too high at the moment. And the way to do that is we're going to increase the storativity, because that drops the Theis curve. And you can see now that it is coming down, but the Theis curve is steeper than the data. So now is the time to change the transmissivity. We increase the transmissivity to flatten the curve. Okay, I'm almost there. Okay, the type curve is parallel to the data, but it's too low. I want to reduce the storativity. So you can see I can use the slider, that's for doing quick adjustments, or we just click on it, and that makes smaller adjustments. Okay. Now, down here, we see the error. So at the moment, it looks like our calculated values are all above our measured values. We want to bring that down a bit, so maybe we reduce our storativity a bit. Actually, that's going the wrong way. Okay, when we're quite close to the perfect number, we can have a look at our RMS error. 0.867, okay, that's not improving it. 6, I think it's here. Go the other way. I don't know why it's not reacting today. 5, 6, okay, 5, 6, okay. So that's a fairly good fit. This is zero here. You see most of the data is on the type curve. And we have a transmissivity of 1,144 and a storativity 1.9 times 10 to the minus 4. We can have a look at the chart. So that's not a bad fit. Okay, so I hope that you found that interesting and informative and that you enjoyed it. Thank you very much for your attention.